Good morning, all of you. Good morning. So yesterday we were talking about the properties of systems. And this was the first question that we need to check these properties for the given equation. So this equation, it connects the relation between input and output. Input of the system is x of n, output is y of n. So you have a relation or a mathematical connection between the input and output. Clear? And what the system is doing is, the system is adding u of n plus 1 to the input whatever you are giving. The input is represented by x of n. And when you give that input x of n to the system will add u of n plus 1 so that you will get the output y of n. This is the task that is performed by the system. So that is evident from the given equation. And we need to check whether the given system is linear or not, time invariant or not, memory less or not, causal or not, and finally, we need to check the stability of the system as well. All these five properties we need to check with respect to the given equation. Clear? I hope it is audible for you. One of you can respond.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. So first we will check the linearity property. Hope you have gone through the theoretical portion of linearity. As I told you before, linear system is nothing but a system that satisfies the superposition principle. Superposition principle in the sense, if you give a weighted sum of inputs, corresponding to the weighted sum of inputs, the output of the system should be also a weighted sum corresponding to the individual responses. Okay. So first we will check the linearity of the system.
Linearity. So to check the linearity, what I will do is, first I will write the task performed by the system. The task performed by the system is nothing but transformation of x of n. Okay. So in what way this x of n is getting transformed? When x of n is getting transformed, it will become y of n such that y of n is equal to x of n plus u of n plus 1. So this is the actual task performed by the system. That is, whatever you give the input, whatever x of n that you are giving to the input of the system will be adding u of n plus 1 along with the input so that you will get the final output as y of n. So that is the task which is performed by the system. Now in the second step, what you will do is, you will give weighted sum of input. Instead of providing x of n as such, what you will do is, you will be giving the weighted sum of inputs. Okay. In the first step, what I have written is, I have written the task performed by the system, that's transformation of x of n. How this x of n is being transformed to y of n. That is what is being mentioned in the first step. Okay. Secondly, what I will do is, instead of giving x of n as such, I will be giving the weighted sum of inputs. Weighted sum of input means you are giving ax1 of n plus bx2 of n, means we are splitting the inputs into two sequences, x1 of n and x2 of n, and then multiplying each signals by a scaling factor a and b respectively, and then we are adding. That is what is called as weighted sum of two inputs. Okay. Now instead of giving x of n, I am giving ax1 of n plus bx2 of n as the input, then what will be your output? You know the working of the system. Whatever the input you are providing, the system will be adding u of n plus 1 along with the input. So here, the output will be like this. Means the input that you are providing now plus u of n plus 1. This is the output corresponding to the weighted sum of inputs. So let it be equation number 1. What is this equation number 1 means? Equation number 1 means this is the output corresponding to weighted sum of inputs.
No.
Okay. The working of the system is such that whatever you are giving as the input, the output will be just u of n plus 1 will get added to the input. So the same logic I have applied here. I have applied ax1 of n plus bx2 of n as the input. So your output will be just u n plus 1 will get added along with the ax1 of n plus bx2 of n. Let it be question number 1. Now I will check the individual responses. Okay. So second part is weighted sum of outputs. Weighted sum of output. What do you mean by weighted sum of output? It is a y1 of n plus b y2 of n. A y1 of n plus b y2 of n. And what is this y1 of n? Y1 of n is the transformation of x1 of n. Yeah. So instead of putting y1 of n, we will write transformation of x1 of n plus b into transformation of x2 of n. Now, what is the transformation of x1 of n? That is, if you are giving x1 of n as the input, then the output will be x1 of n plus u of n plus 1. Isn't it? So the transformation of x1 of n is nothing but x1 of n plus u of n plus 1 according to the work that is performed by the system. And a is common to all these terms, so you will put a bracket over here plus what is the second term? B into transformation of x2 of n is similarly, it will be x2 of n plus u of n plus 1. X2 of n plus u of n plus 1. Now you just open the bracket and simplify. So it will be ax1 of n plus au of n plus 1 plus bx2 of n plus bu of n plus 1. Let it be equation number 2. What does this equation number 2 implies? What does this equation number 2 means? It is the weighted sum of individual responses. Okay. Equation number 2 means that it is the weighted sum of individual responses. Individual response in the sense, if you are giving x1 of n as the input, you will get y1 of n. If you are giving x2 of n as the input, then you will get the responses y2 of n, and then you will find the weighted sum of the input. How can transformation of x2 of n give even a un plus 1 term? Because as far as the question is concerned, this is the equation of your system. Whatever you are giving as input, the output will be input plus u of n plus 1. Output is nothing but input plus u of n plus 1. So if you are giving x of n as the input, then the output will be x of n plus u of n plus 1. If you are giving x1 of n as the input, output will be x1 of n plus u of n plus 1, like that. Is that clear? Now, equation number 2 corresponds to the weighted sum of, what is equation number 2? It is nothing but the weighted sum of individual responses. Now, I will compare 1 and 2. But unfortunately, 1 is not equal to 2. You can see equation number 1 is ax1 of n plus bx2 of n plus u of n plus 1. But equation number 2 is ax1 of n plus au of n plus 1 plus bx2 of n plus bu of n plus 1. Therefore, equation number 1 is not equal to equation number 2. Implies superposition principle is not satisfied. Superposition is
not satisfied. What is superposition?
Any weighted
sum of inputs must results in a weighted sum of individual responses.
So that is not happening. So superposition is not satisfied. Hence the system is non-linear. I will explain once again.
Please listen.
So this is what is the equation that is provided for you.
Means it is a relation between the input and output of the system. Input here is x of n, output here is y of n. So the task or the operation or the work performed by the system is such that whenever you give any input x of n, like it can be x1, x2 or whatever it may be, okay, any input you give to the system, the output is nothing but input plus u of n plus 1. Okay, so this is the relation between the input and output. This is the actual transformation of the input that is performed by the system. Now you need to check the linearity first. So what I will do is, I will rewrite that transformation of x of n is equal to y of n. Means whatever you are giving as the input x of n, it is getting transformed to y of n, and y of n is nothing but input x of n plus u of n plus 1. Now, rather than giving this input x of n, now I will give the weighted sum of input. Weighted sum of input is nothing but ax1 of n plus bx2 of n. Here also, you have to assume that this ax1 of n plus bx2 of n is the entire output input that you are giving. So the transformation process that is happening is input plus u of n plus 1. What is the input over here? Input is ax1 of n plus bx2 of n. Along with that, another term will get added. That is nothing but u of n plus 1. This is equation number 1. Equation number 1 means it is nothing but the output corresponding to the weighted sum of inputs. That is, instead of giving x of n as such, I have given weighted sum of inputs, that is ax1 of n plus bx2 of n. Corresponding to this particular input, the output that is provided to us is ax1 of n plus bx2 of n plus u of n plus 1 according to equation number 1. Now to check the linearity, I should come to the right hand side. Right hand side is nothing but the weighted sum of individual response. So these two equations should be equal. So now I will come to towards the weighted sum of outputs. Weighted sum of outputs is nothing but a y1 of n plus b y2 of n. Y1 of n is nothing but transformation of x1 of n. Y2 of n is nothing but transformation of x2 of n. You know what is the task performed by the system? Whenever you are giving x1 of n as the input, the output is nothing but that input plus u of n plus 1. So x1 of n plus u of n plus 1. Whenever you are giving an input as x2 of n, the transformation performed by the system is x2 of n plus u of n plus 1. And you will have a constant a and b outside the bracket. Now you expand that equation, that will be equation number 2. Equation number 2 corresponds to weighted sum of individual responses, and equation number 1 corresponds to output corresponding to weighted sum of inputs. These should be equal to each other. But unfortunately, here you can see equation number 1 is not equal to 2. Therefore, our superposition principle is not satisfied, and hence the system is non-linear. So please take down. If you have any doubts, please ask. So this is the concept of linearity. I repeat, most of the students are late to the class. This will be seriously viewed and your attendance will be blocked. You know, this is a recorded session and your attendance is recorded. Your participation is being recorded, and according to that only the attendance will be available to you. Okay, when the time of your login, the time of your logout, everything will be considered in record. According to this only the attendance will be granted for you. So please be serious about the classes. You have to be regular. You have to be punctual. Okay, the time of entrance is nothing but 9 a.m. So sharp 9 a.m. you have to get into the class. Don't get delay. Parents have provided all the systems for, all the facilities for you. But you need to make utilize of all these things. Don't be lazy. Okay. So this 2 years is crucial for you. Kindly utilize it properly and have a bright future. Okay. Class is scheduling at 9, but you people will be coming at 9:15, 9:30 and all, then there is no use. continuity of the class will go. You won't be able to understand the concept. Taking this as problematic paper, if you don't know the problems, how to do the problems, it is difficult for you. So kindly be regular and punctual. So this is what is the linearity. Now second one we'll go to time invariant. Second property, time invariant.
Can I rub the board? So for the same question we are going to check all the properties starting from linearity, time invariance, memory loss, causal and stability. Second property we'll go and check. The time invariance property. So same system we are making use of, same equation, we need to check the time invariance property. Time invariant. I repeat the concept of time invariant.
Time invariant means whenever you are giving a delay or shift to the input signal, corresponding shift should be applicable to the output also. Then you can say that the system is time invariant. Otherwise, if that shift is not coming to the right side, I mean the output side, then it is called as time variant system. So whatever the shift that is you are applying towards the input signal, the same shift is to be apply, I mean it should be applicable at the output also, it should be reflected at the output also, then you can say that the system is time invariant, otherwise it is time variant.
So how to check?
So that is a concept of checking with the time invariant, but now we need to check problem wise how we are going to check the system. I mean there should be some procedure to check the time invariant property of a given system.
So for that what I will do is, first I will give delay or provide delay. Your delay means shift, okay? Provide delay to input. Provide the delay to the input signal. Input is nothing but x of n. Okay,
so we are providing time delay to x of n. Correspondingly, what will be the output? Y of n.
So when x of n is getting delayed, it will become x of n minus k.
When x of n is getting delayed, it means it is being shifted towards right side, that is x of n minus k. Is that clear? X of n is your input. When it is getting delayed means it will shift towards right side, that is x of n minus k. So I have applied a shift towards the input x of n, so that now it is becoming x of n minus k. Corresponding to this input, what will be your output?
So the output corresponding to this output corresponding to the input x of n minus k can be written as, how can it be written?
Y of n minus k.
Earlier you have provided the input x of n, and corresponding to this input you are having an output, that is y of n. But now what you are providing x of n minus k. Instead of providing x of n, you are giving x of n minus k, that is a delayed version of x of n or shifted version of x of n. So this input you need to provide to the system, and you need to find the output of the system. So that output corresponding to this delayed input is nothing but y of n comma k. What is n comma k? That is, output is a function of both n and k, because you can see x is a function of both n and k. So as of now you can't write y of n, the new output, you can't write y of n as such. You need to show the effect of k also. So what you will do is you will provide the output corresponding to the input x of n minus k as y of n comma k is equal to, instead of writing x of n, what should I replace here?
Instead of writing x of n, what should I do? What should I write?
K
x of n minus
k. X of n minus k. I need to write x of n minus k.
So y of n comma k is equal to x of n minus k plus u of n plus 1. Please be aware that u of n plus 1 is not the input. The only input that you have is x of n. So you have provided the shift only for x of n. Is that clear? U of n plus 1 will be as such. There is no change for u of n plus 1. You have provided the delay or shift only to the input x of n. Corresponding to that shift, you have rewritten your output as y of n comma k. Let it be equation number 1. Is this is clear for everybody? I will explain once more. The first equation, whatever you have, this is your given equation of the system. That is, you have the relation between x of n and y of n as given. That is, y of n equal to x of n plus u of n plus 1. Now, I need to check the time invariance. And you know the concept of time invariance. That is, you will be giving some shift to the input signal. And correspondingly, you need to check whether your output is also getting delayed. Isn't it? The same shift, it should appear at the output also. So for that, what you are doing is, you will be providing a delay to the input. That delay is nothing but x of n minus k. Please be aware about the fact that you are giving only the delay to input alone, not to u of n plus 1. U of n plus 1 will be as such. So now x of n can be rewritten as x of n minus k. So since your output is now depending upon both factors n and k, now you need to write the new output y of n comma k instead of putting y of n. Why? Because your output is now, it is a function of both n as well as k. So it will be y of n comma k is equal to x of n, instead of putting x of n, you will have x of n minus k plus u of n plus 1. That is the equation number 1. This is the first step that you have. Next, what you will do is providing delay to the output. So you may ask, how can we give delay to y of n? But this is just for analyzing the system's property. Physically we can't do, practically we can't, provide delay to the output. We are going to analyze the output only. But in order to check whether the same time shift is happening at the output also, we need to provide the time delay to y of n while doing the problem. Clear? Our intention is to check whether the system is time invariant or not. For that, what I have done, I will be giving a delay to the input and I will be checking whether that delay is applicable to the output also, whether I am getting the same delayed version at the output also, that we are going to find out. So for that, I need to put a delay to y of n. So this y of n, now it will become y of n minus k. So you just replace this equation. Now I am going to replace y of n as y of n minus k. So what you need to do, since you are replacing left hand side you are replacing, isn't it? You are replacing y of n will become y of n minus k. So in that case, what you should do, so for example, suppose you have an equation for f of x and you need to write f of t, what you need to do then? You need to replace x with a t, isn't it? Suppose you have a function f of x with you, you need to write f of t, then what you must do? You must replace x with a t. Wherever you find the variable x, in that space you need to fill with a t, isn't it? Similarly, here you have an equation for y of n, and now you are writing equation for y of n minus k. So what will be the new equation? Can anybody tell? Sheikh Musa? Musa can tell? What will be the new equation? You have y of n with you. You need to write y of n minus k. But what should you do? Unmute and speak. You need to respond to the class. Otherwise, there is no point in sitting. Stanley Davis, how you are going to write y of n minus k?
So replace n with n minus k through.
Yes, replace n with n minus k throughout the equation.
So y of n will become y of n minus k. Very good, Stanley. Y of n will become y of n minus k equal to x of n minus k. Instead of putting n, you will have n minus k plus, instead of putting u of n plus 1, it will be u of n minus k plus 1. This is equation number 2. Now you need to check whether this 1 is equal to 2 or not. What is the purpose of checking this 1 and 2? What's the purpose of comparing this 1 and 2? Because you need to check whether the same shift is being applied at the output also, or you are getting the same signal at the output also. Okay, whatever you are getting in the equation number 1, it should happen at equation number 2 also. The right hand side should be same, because the same signal but with a different shift you are going to have, I mean, you are going to access at the output terminal, isn't it? Suppose you have a signal x of n, you have shifted that x of n, and correspondingly that same shift should be applicable at the right hand side also, that is at the output also. So you will be checking the two equations whether they are equal to each other. You compare the right hand side, this is x of minus k plus u of n plus 1, this is x of n minus k plus u of n minus k plus 1. Isn't it? So these equations are not equal to each other, therefore the system is not time invariant, or it can be called as time variant system. Time variant system. So I repeat the procedure. What you need to do is you need to put delay to the input alone. First you need to put the delay to the input alone, then you need to rewrite the equation. Secondly, you need to provide the delay at the output. When you are providing the delay to the output, means throughout you need to replace n as n minus k. Wherever you have n at the right side, you need to replace with n minus k. And then you need to compare the right hand side of the two equations. And if they are not equal to each other, then it means that they are time variant system or not a time invariant system.
Sir, one doubt.
Yes.
Sir, in the last term for a u of n plus 1, sir, why are we substituting that also with n minus k? Because that's a constant, no, sir, like it's a unit step function.
Suppose I will tell you a simple example. It is not a constant. U of n minus k plus 1 is not a constant. See, suppose f of x is equal to 3x square plus x, like that you have, then what it will be f of t? F of t is equal to 3t square plus t. Similarly, here also y of y of n equal to x of n plus u of n plus 1. So to put y of n minus k, you need to replace n with n minus k. That simple function, max function, mathematical function. Wherever you have n, you need to put n minus k.
So then in the first equation, why are we not doing that?
Why are we not doing that? Because there we are providing, have clearly mentioned, we have providing delay to the input, not output. We are providing the delay to the input, and correspondingly you are taking the output. When left hand side you are modifying, means right hand side all the terms should modify. But in the first step we are modifying only the input. Correspondingly the output is written as y of n comma k, means it will be a function of both n and k. Understood?
So sir, we are writing y of n comma k because we don't know like what will be the effect.
Yeah, very good. Yes, that is the point. We don't know what is the effect. So that is why I can assume this is a function of n comma k alone. That is why I have written it. Now is that clear?
Okay, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. So I repeat, for the first statement, you are providing delay only to the input. That is why I am not changing u of n plus 1. But in the second case, we are providing the delay to the output. So the output is depending on two factors, x of n and u of n plus 1. So for both the terms, you need to change the parameter n with n minus k. And now you compare the right hand side of the two equations. Since they are not equal to each other, it is a time variant system or non-time invariant system. Kindly take it down as soon as possible.
Now the third property you need to check with respect to the same system is, can I rub the board? The third property you need to check is, what is the third property? It is memory property. Third property you need to check is the memory or memoryless property. Again, the same equation you need to write, because we need to check all the five properties with regard to the same equation. So the equation that is provided to you is y of n is equal to x of n plus u of n plus 1. And kindly recall the concept of memory and memoryless system. A system is said to have memory if it depends on the past inputs. If the present output is depending on past input, means it is having memory. But if the present output is depending only on the present input, then it doesn't have any memory, or it is a memoryless system. So for that, what you will do is, we'll put n equal to 0 and check. Put n equal to 0. So y of 0 is equal to x of 0 plus u of 1. Forget about this u of 1, because this is not the input. The only input that you have here is x of n. U of 1 is something which is getting added to x of n, so don't bother about that. Again, you can check for 1 also, it will be x of 1 plus u of 2. Or you can put negative also, x of minus 1 plus u of 0. So in all these cases, if you check these terms, you check the output is depending on present values of input, isn't it? The output is depending upon the present values of input. So you write that output depends only on present values of input. Therefore, it is memoryless system. Suppose if it was depending upon the past input values, then we should write it is having memory system. I mean, it is a memory system. Now it is a memoryless system. Why? Because it is depending only on present values of input. So it is memoryless system. Okay. So this I just wrote for your reference only. That does not need to put and see, because by observation itself you will be able to understand. So I need only the comment. There is no marks for this. Just I have written for your checking purpose. Okay. Otherwise, if you discard the step directly, you can write this comment. The comment is output depends only on the present values of input. Therefore, it is a memoryless system. Okay. Directly, you can comment and write answer. No need to put n equal to 0, 1, minus 1 and all. Just for your reference only, I made that for your clarity. Okay. Any doubts with regard to this memory and memoryless system? Please take it down. Then we will go for the next property, that is causality. The fourth property you have is causal. The fourth property that you have is causal system. Whether we need to check the system is causal or not. And kindly recall the property of causality. If a system depends on present or past values of input alone and not on the future, then it can be called as causal. But if there is any term that depends on future values of input, then it will be non-causal. Either it should depend on present alone, or it should depend upon past alone, or it can be a combination of present and past also, but there should not be any future terms. If it is depending upon future values of the input, then it should be a non-causal system. So take down the equation again. What was the equation that you have given? y of n is equal to x of n plus u of n plus 1. Again, you can check whether n equal to 0. It is understood that y of 0 is equal to x of 0 plus u of 1. See, this is depending only on the present input, right? Again, y of 1 is equal to x of 1 plus u of 2. Like that it will go. So, you can write the output depends only on present and not future. So if a system is a causal system, then it is also a memory system. No. In the last version, we have told it is a memoryless system, but this is a causal system. In the last case, I told you, in the third property, I told you that was a memoryless system, but this is a causal system. So output depends only on present and not on future. Since it is not depending upon the future, therefore it is causal. If it is depending upon future, then it will be non-causal. So this is a causal system. At the same time, this is a memoryless system also. Why? Because it is not depending upon the past. It is only depending upon the present. But all the case, we can't tell any causal system will be also a memoryless system. That also we can't tell. Because memoryless means it should depend only on present. Suppose I put like this animation, x of n plus x of n minus.